आपले प्रोजेक्ट काय परत झालं म्हणजे
ओके गुड आफ्टरनून ओके वील कंटिन्यू लास्ट प्रॉब्लेम आई थिंक टू स्टेप्स ऑफ द लास्ट प्रॉब्लेम वी हैव कवर्ड सो वील स्टार्ट नेक्स्ट स्टेप दैट इज स्टेप नंबर 3 So what is step number 3? So before step 3, we will write first properties of selected sections. So I think we have selected ISLB 500, correct? We have selected this section, ISLB 500. So the properties of this section is nothing but suppose small h is the depth of section is 500 mm, then we want width of flange bf. Everyone please open the steel table and find these all properties. I think last lecture we have find only z value, so here find all the values, h, then bf, then thickness of flange tf is required, then tw is required, then iyy is required, so find the properties ISLB 500 h is equal to 500 how much width of flange please open the steel table and see the ISLB 500 I think width of flange how much 180 mm correct please everyone open the steel table. In step number 2 we have selected the section ISLB 500. You can see step number 2. In step number 2, okay, so width of flange is 180 mm, then thickness of flange TF I think 14.1 mm, everyone please see, then thickness of wave 9.2 mm, then moment of inertia iyy, how much moment of inertia about y axis, sorry, IYY and IYXX both write down. So IXX how much? IXX is 38579 into 10^4 mm^4, and IYY is 1063.9 into 10^4 mm^4. So these are the properties of given section. Now go to step number 3. This is step number 2 actually, and we have calculated the ZP for this. How much ZP value we have calculated? 17. How much calculated value, final ZP value? can tell me at the end finally ZP value calculated from ZE. From ZE we have calculated ZP. The ZE was 1759. Okay, 1759, correct. 1759 into 10^3 mm³. And ZE was this. Okay. So this is the our selected section and their properties. Now step number 3, classify the section. Step number 3, classify the section. Okay, everyone please write down this ISLB 500 properties. Classify the section. So we have to classify for first flange. For flange we have to classify the section. So for flange we have to this is the formula we have given in the please see the procedure. Step number 3, we have given the procedure. In the procedure for flange, BF divided by 2 just a minute BF by 2 divided by TF. Okay, so BF is 180 divided by 2 divided by TF is here 14.1. so how much this value? Classify the section. Under step 3 we have to classify the section. So classification, it means for flange we have to use this formula BF by 2 divided by TF. So by using this, how much value we got? Please anyone, please see the procedure. I have given this procedure 6.38. Someone has given me this value is in mm. This is not in mm because BF is in mm, TF is in mm. So mm get cancelled. This is the factor. So now this value is less than 9.4. See, this value is less than 9.4 epsilon. Actually, this here epsilon is there, but value of epsilon is 1. So we are not writing here. So here I have given you, this is 6.38 less than 9.4. It means section is plastic. See the procedure I have given in written. How to classify the section? If the BF by 2 divided by TF, this value is less than 9.4, plastic section. It is less than 10.5, then compact. Like this I have given in the procedure. This is very important related to examination, MCQ examination. Khup important question ahe MCQ sathi tumhala. This 9.4, 10.5, then less than 15 and greater than 15. This is compact, semi-compact, compact, semi-compact and slender. So if the BF by 2 divided by TF value is less than 9.4, then section is plastic. if bf by 2 divided by tf, this value is less than 10.5, then section is compact. Similarly, less than 15, section is semi-compact, and similarly, greater than 15, section is slender. Okay, so our section is plastic. As per our section properties, our section is plastic. Okay, so this is the classification for flange. Now classification for wave. See the formula for wave classification, d divided by tw. So here, what is d? d is nothing but, here d and h both are the same. D is the depth of section. So we are calling as a height of section also. So d and h are the same value, that is the 500 value. So here put the value of d. And tw, how much tw? 9.2. Okay, so d is 500 and tw is 9.2. So how much this value? How much? 54.35. Okay. 54.35. It should be less than how much? 84. See, less than 84. It means it is again plastic. See the procedure I have given in detail for flange, when plastic section is there, when compact section, when semi-compact section, and when slender section. If the calculation of this term, BF by 2 divided by TF and D by TW, for these two, I have given here these values, less than 9.4, less than 10. Here like this, for wave, less than 84, then less than 105, then less than 126 and greater than 126. So like this, we have given the, I have given the these values in the procedure also. And this is available in again IS code also. Okay. So here for wave and for flange also, the section is plastic. Section is plastic, it means what? Suppose this is the I section. This is the depth of section, 500 mm. It, when this section is underloading at wave, if any plastic hinge is forming, at flange any plastic hinge is forming. If the plastic hinges are formed, then this section goes into the plastic zone. So we are calling, or we are classifying the zones of, for zone purpose. It means the section is going gone into the plastic zone or in elastic zone. For that purpose, we are classifying this. म्हणजे सध्या कुठल्या स्टेजला तो सेक्शन गेलेला आहे, फुल्ली प्लास्टिक आहे की कॉम्पॅक्ट स्टेज मध्ये आहे किंवा सेमी कॉम्पॅक्ट मध्ये आहे का स्लेंडर आहे, म्हणजेच बिहेवियर मी तुम्हाला दाखवलं होतं अशा पद्धतीचं आहे. दिस इज द स्लेंडर बिहेवियर, म्हणजे अजून इलास्टिक झोन मध्ये आहे. या ठिकाणचं बिहेवियर आहे ते सेमी कॉम्पॅक्ट, या ठिकाणचं बिहेवियर आहे कॉम्पॅक्ट, आणि या ठिकाणचं एंडचं बिहेवियर आहे प्लास्टिक. ॲट प्लास्टिक सेक्शन विल बी दी कोलॅप्स. ॲट सेमी कॉम्पॅक्ट या ठिकाणी काहीतरी हिंजेस फॉर्म झाले असतात, सॉरी कॉम्पॅक्टला. सेमी कॉम्पॅक्टला नुसतेच हिंजेस, तुमचा सेक्शन आहे तो इलॅस्टिकमधून प्लास्टिक झोनमध्ये एंट्री करत असतो सेमी कॉम्पॅक्टला, आणि सिलेंडरमध्ये विद इन द इलॅस्टिक लिमिट. सो दीज आर दी फोर क्लासिफिकेशन्स ऑफ दी युअर सेक्शन. तुमचा कोणताही आय सेक्शन असेल, चॅनल सेक्शन असेल, ज्यावेळी तो लोडिंग कंडिशनमध्ये असेल त्यावेळी किती लोड आलाय त्याच्यावरून तो सिलेंडरमध्ये आहे, सेमी कॉम्पॅक्टमध्ये आहे की कॉम्पॅक्टमध्ये आहे की प्लास्टिकमध्ये आहे. सो दिस इज द व्हेरी इम्पॉर्टंट क्वेश्चन रिलेटेड टू एक्झामिनेशन लाईक एम सी क्यू ऑर एनी. सो वी हॅव टू कीप इन माइंड दिस फॉर्म्युलीज फॉर दी क्लासिफिकेशन पर्पज. सो दिस इज व्हेरी व्हेरी इम्पॉर्टंट रिलेटेड टू एक्झामिनेशन ऑर एम सी क्यू एक्झामिनेशन. सो तुम्ही आता जर समजा तुमची एक्झाम ऑनलाईन होणार असेल एम सी क्यू, तर तुम्हाला खूप इम्पॉर्टंट आहे हा फॉर्म्युला आणि ह्या व्हॅल्यू चार, 9.4, 10.5, 15 आणि 15. सिमिलरली 84, 105. सो दीज आर दी व्हेरी इम्पॉर्टंट व्हॅल्यूज फॉर फ्लॅंज अँड वेब. सो आय हॅव गिवन इन डिटेल इन दी प्रोसिजर. सो कीप इन माइंड दीज व्हॅल्यूज विथ पर्टिक्युलर क्लासिफिकेशन, प्लास्टिक, कॉम्पॅक्ट, सेमी कॉम्पॅक्ट अँड सिलेंडर. आर यू गेटिंग? Okay, so here step number 3 is now over. So step number 4. So go to step number 4. What is step number 4? Calculate design shear strength. No? Design shear strength. For resistance. Calculate design shear strength for resistance. So shear strength for resistance, that is nothing but VDR. Design shear strength for resistance, VDR. So formula is Fy into gamma m, sorry, Fy into Aw divided by under root of 3 gamma m naught. Okay, so now put the values here. So Fy is 250. Now Aw, Aw is nothing but what I have given in the procedure. Aw is H into Tw divided by under root of 3 gamma Mw. So here 250 into H is the 500 into Tw, thickness of wave, divided by under root of 3 into gamma M naught is 1.1. So how much this value? VDR is the design shear strength, is in kilonewton or is in newton, because this value, tell me in kilonewton. The calculation, it will be come in newton, so tell me in kilonewton. Do the calculations first. Six zero three point five nine kilonewton is the shear strength. Okay, correct. Okay, so now we have to take check. So how much shear? How much shear force we have to take here check? So check is VDR. How to take check? VDR is greater than VD. So VDR is 603.59 and VD is how much? And second check is VD is less than 0.6 VDR. So 0.6 into 603.59. How much this value? VD is how much? पहिल्या स्टेप मध्ये व्हीडी कॅल्क्युलेट केलाय आपण. किती आहे व्हीडी? 175. करेक्ट. सो 175 अँड हिअर 175. सो हाऊ मच दिस व्हॅल्यू हिअर? 0.6 इंटू 603. दिस सो दिस इज ग्रेटर दॅन, हेन्स सेफ हिअर. On this side, 0.6 into 603. How much? Now here, what? Here 175 is less than 362. It means this also safe. So hence safe. It means calculated actual shear force and shear force is required, shear force is greater than the actual shear force. VD ha actual design shear force ahe ani resistance sathi lagnara shear force ahe, that is the 603. It means it is greater than this, so hence safe. So whatever calculations and section chosen for shear resistance, manje apan jo section choose kela to shear sathi safe ahe. ISLB 500. Okay. So now, next step. Step number 5. What is step number 5? Design bending moment. Design bending moment. So we have to calculate the bending moment. Now for here laterally supported beam is there. See the problem statement. For lateral okay, so for laterally supported beam, MDR is equal to beta B into ZP into FY divided by gamma M naught. See. And for laterally unsupported beam, here FBD is there. Instead of FY, FBD is there for laterally unsupported beam. And this is the laterally supported beam. So you, if you read the problem statement, they are written, the laterally supported beam is written. So here the change is, instead of here FBD, FY is there for laterally supported beam. So now put the values. Okay. So now what is the value of beta B? So beta B is equal to 1 for plastic and compact section. The value of beta B is 1 for plastic and compact section. Okay, so now put the values. MDR is equal to beta B is 1 into ZP value. How much ZP value we have calculated finally? 17 final value of ZP. Here we have written at the top 1759. Into 10^3 into Fy is 250 divided by gamma m naught is 1.1. So now calculate MDR here. MDR is in where kilonewton meter, because actually these units are newton mm. So convert into kilonewton meter. The calculation tumcha newton mm madhe yel, tela kilonewton meter madhe convert kara. How much? 399.77 kilonewton meter. Okay. So this is the MDR. Now check for moment. Now check for bending moment. So how to take check? So MDR should be greater than MD. So MDR is 399.77 kilonewton meter, and MD is how much? MD we have calculated in step 1. MD is 350. So MD is 350 and calculated MDR. MDR means again design moment for the resistance here. So we can write here. So you can write a bending moment for resistance also here. Bending moment for resistance. Okay, so hence shape. Okay, MDR is greater than MD. So hence shape. So MDR is 399.77 and MD is 350. And the design moment he tumchi. Actually moment for resistance hi tumchi design moment peksha jast alele, so hence shape. Ani jar shape nahi ali tar aplyala parat mota section choose karaycha jyachi z chi value jast ahe. Lakshat yete ka? Jasa apan unit number 3 4 madhe apan pahilo hota area jar section jar unshape ala tar jast area cha section choose karaycha. Tasach idhe kay karaycha? Jar MDR shear force या जर व्हॅल्यू जर चितला चेक जर सॅटिस्फाय नाही झाला तर आपल्याला काय करायचं तर जास्त झेड असलेला व्हॅल्यू सेक्शन परत चूज करायचा. आर यू गेटिंग? इफ दिस एमडीआर आणि एमडी कॅल्क्युलेटेड मूव्हमेंट इज नॉट सेफ ऑर शिअर फोर्स इज नॉट सेफ, देन यू हॅव टू चूज हायर झेड व्हॅल्यू सेक्शन. ओके, सो स्टेप नंबर 5 इज ओव्हर. Now step number 6. What is step 6? Checks for design of beam. In that first check we have to take, that is check for wave buckling. Check for wave buckling. Okay, so how to take or calculate buckling strength? FWB. FW is the buckling strength. FW is the buckling strength. So what is formula? B plus 2N1 into TW into FCD. So we have to calculate buckling strength for this section. म्हणजे जो आपण ISLB 500 सेक्शन चूज केलाय तो सेक्शन किती त्याची बकलिंग स्ट्रेंथ किती असेल. सो चेक फॉर वेब बकलिंग. सो नाउ हियर वी हैव टू कैलकुलेट बकलिंग स्ट्रेंथ. सो फॉर दिस नाउ हियर बी, व्हाट इज बी और बी वन, हियर बी वन इज रिटर्न ना. हाँ, व्हाट इज फॉर्मूला बी वन और बी आई हैव गिवन in the procedure. I think B1 is given. Okay, B1, correct. So now B1, what is B1? B1 is the width of flange. How much width of flange? I think 180 mm, correct? B1 is the width of flange, 180 mm. Now N1, how to calculate N1? N1 is equal to D by 2. So D is 500 by 2 is 250 mm. N1 is 250 mm. Now TW is again given, thickness of wave, that is 9.2 mm is given. And now we have to calculate here FCD. So these are the given values. So we have to calculate. So now here unknown is only FCD. So we have to calculate FCD. So how to calculate FCD? So before calculation of FCD, we have to calculate. So right here, to find FCD. So we have to calculate slenderness ratio, SR. So how to calculate slenderness ratio? So 2.425 into D by TW. In this way, we have to calculate slenderness ratio. So 2.425 into D is 500 and TW is 9.2. So calculate slenderness ratio. Slenderness ratio. How much? One thirty one point seven nine. Okay, so 131.79 is the slenderness ratio. Now, as I have given, so for buckling class C, for buckling class C and FY is equal to 250 MPa. So we have to go page number 42, table number 9C, IS 800, and find the value of FCD. Everyone please go to table number 9C, page number 42. IS 800.